Hello everyone, welcome to our channel Explore Life with Shutapa. Today we are back with a video on monsoon birding at Baruipur. Baruipur is a place situated at the outskirts of Kolkata and still has a few patches of green. In the monsoon season and in the winter, this place is visited by a lot of birds. So today, we have come to this place to explore. So let's start our exploration. Be with us and watch the video till the end without skipping. On 25th August 2024, we decided to explore the Baruipur outskirts for monsoon birding. Around the monsoon season, the grasslands around Kolkata are filled with bitterns, prineas, zittingisticolas, herons, jacanas and munias. We started around 6 a.m. in the morning and took the route to Baruipur outskirts. Long drives in monsoon has its own charm and we are addicted to it. On our way, we soaked ourselves in the greens and also enjoyed the village life. We reached the location at around 7 a.m. I will share the location of the birding around this place in the description box. If you are interested, you can check that. After entering the area, we first went to the location at the back of the Tele Academy. One thing to mention here is, in this location, almost all the roads have huge potholes filled with rainwater, so be very careful while driving. We had to take the route straight to the front of the Tele Academy and then took the side road which goes near the pond to go to the back side. While going to the backside of the Tele Academy, when we checked in the pond, there were no sign of bird and there was also almost no activity in the grassland. But we continued going to the backside. You can see the road conditions from this video, so be careful while you are driving. We reached the end of the road and here you have to park your car. And there are grassland throughout this area which you can explore. I could hear a lot of activity in the grasslands. There were munias flying inside the grassland. The grey-headed swamp hen was taking short flight in the grassland. However, everything was too distant to shoot. We went ahead and suddenly we spotted something on the wire. It was two shikras. They were sitting apart from each other, so I could not get a shot of them in a single frame, but I got a good shot of the shikra sitting on the wire. Shikras are raptors and resident bird of Kolkata. It is also known as banded goshawk. It hunts on a variety of prey in woodlands, grasslands, and even suburban gardens. After spending some time there, we decided to go to the first lane, as there was almost no activity in this area. On the way back to lane 1, on the wires, electric wires, I spotted some birds. They were ashy wood swallows. I took a shot of them, but it was against light. Ashy wood swallows are birds of open areas and are often found perched on wires. They are often found together in pairs or in tight groups when at rest. In this rainy season, due to waterlogging in this lane 1, this road is not at all motorable, and we parked our car at the side of the road at the mouth of lane 1, and then I walked on the lane. On the lane 1, on the left hand side, there are grasslands, while on the right hand side, there are a few marshes. I spotted quite a few birds and there were a lot of activity in the grasslands. I spotted the common moorhen, bronze pink jacana, white-breasted water hen in the water bodies. I could not find any peasant in jacana. The grasslands were filled with preen prinias and zitting gesticolas. There were a few birds on the wire, and on closer look, there seemed to be some munias, but they flew away on seeing me. And there was a bird which was hovering over the grassland and it sat on a wire. On closer look, it was a black winged kite. Black-winged kite is a beautiful falcon-like kite. Found in open grassland, they are often seen hovering over open lands for prey. But where are the munias? The tricolor munias are quite common in the grasslands around Kolkata in monsoon, though the red munia is a bit rare. But I could sight none of them. With the rain, it was so beautiful all around that I decided to stay there for some time and wait for any bird to appear which I can shoot in the rain. I decided to spend the time with myself and with nature. And after some time, I was blessed. After some time, a flock of munia came on the road to feed on something. There was a chestnut munia in that flock. Tricolor munias are also called as black-headed munias, and often in their flock you can find the chestnut munia. They feed on the seeds in the grass and in the reeds during the monsoon time. Initially they flew away on seeing me, but later they were comfortable with me and they allowed me to shoot them and take a few photos and videos. They were like small bundles of energy flying here and there. It was very beautiful to watch them in the monsoon. I got some good shots too, which I really liked. After the munias were gone, I stayed there for some more time in the hope that I will find some more birds. And I was able to see a red bottle lapwing taking a bath and a zitting gesticola calling out to its heart's content. Satisfied and rejuvenated, we started towards home. Life in a metro is very hectic. A weekend morning in such place not only relaxes the body but also the mind and soul. If you don't believe my words, try one weekend going out in such places. You will enjoy and love it. And if you have liked this video, please don't forget to like, share and subscribe. Also, if you have not subscribed to this channel, I would request you to please subscribe. Please click on the notification bell so that every time I upload a video, you will be notified. I will be back soon again with some other exploration of some other place. So till the next video, you all stay healthy, stay happy, and bye for now.